Cold front continues to march offshore, and behind that, dew point temperatures are dropping, which means it turns much drier overnight tonight and cooler as well. Temperatures at least 10 degrees cooler tomorrow, but more importantly, the air is a lot drier. It's going to be a beautiful Sunday. Some fair weather cloudiness north of the Lakes region up through the Notches and the higher ground of Coos County. A few fair weather clouds there, and the dry weather will stay with us into Tuesday. That includes the lower dew point temperatures. And you could see those dew point temperatures. Look at them drop into the 40s and 50s overnight tonight. This is a much drier, much more comfortable air mass. Give the air conditioners a night off. Bust those windows open and let that fresh, cooler, drier air stream in, because it's going to be a lot different during the day tomorrow. Overnight tonight, any leftover clouds will melt away nicely after sunset. Temperatures settle into the 50s, may even see a few upper 40s in some of those cooler mountain valleys. 49 in Whitefield tonight, 50 up in Berlin-Gorham, 57 Conway, Laconia in the Lakes region, 58. And even down to the seacoast, a comfortable 62. Again, the dew point temperature is the key, and that'll be dropping over the course of the evening hours. A beautiful day tomorrow. Again, a few fair weather clouds building as you get up north of Franconia Notch and Crawford Notch up through the Connecticut Lakes. And may see a few batches of heavier cloud cover in the afternoon from time to time, but bright sunshine down to southern New Hampshire and the seacoast, upper 70s to near the 80-degree mark. And again, the big difference will be that nice dry air. Comes in on a northwesterly flow. If you're boating on Winnipesaukee tomorrow or any of the lakes up to Newfound Lake, looking nice. Center Harbor, a light northwest breeze at 5 to 10 knots on the lake. Bright sunshine, 10 to 15 knots over the broad lake. Wave heights less than a foot. Water temperature 78 degrees. And that lake water level up there at 504.37 feet right now. A couple of passing clouds as we get into the week. Now, the remnant moisture from the leftovers of Fred are going to be building to our west, and we may start to tap into some showers by Wednesday. This is 6 o'clock Wednesday. Looks like that first surge of remnant tropical moisture will be pushing through at that time. A little break in the action, but some off and on shower and thunderstorm activity later in the week, possibly into the weekend. Again, it's a tough call. Anytime you get these tropical systems into play here, it really kind of throws a wrench into the gears of the short-range and medium-range computer modeling. We'll keep an eye on that, but right now, the early look at next Saturday, sun in the morning, maybe some pop-up showers in the afternoon. Here's the remnants of Fred working down through the tropics, and that storm, or the remnants of it, are going to be working up across the panhandle of Florida early Tuesday, and then that remnant moisture will continue to push off to the north up through the Tennessee and the Ohio Valley. Ultimately, the core of the, again, keep in mind, remnants of this system will be tracking well to our west of the eastern Great Lakes, but a few pieces of that tropical moisture will be cycling across New England later in the week. 7-day forecast, a beautiful Sunday, mainly sunny, some high thin cloudy this Monday, but otherwise another nice day. Those dew point temperatures remain low. Nighttime temperatures remain comfortable for sleeping. By Wednesday, we may see a few showers. Might be some thunderstorms with those showers on Thursday afternoon. It's going to start to get muggy again. Tropical moisture, that's the key. That's when those dew point temperatures come back up, when these tropical systems draw closer. Showers and storms next Friday. Maybe some showers next Saturday. We'll keep a close watch on that.